Emma's handout. Said let's try this again. Laughing face. Emma's handout. Said hey guys. I am a bot and gonna control your nano leaf lights. For help right, nano help. Powered by www.nanoswitchleafs.com. Then Hamas Hangout is now live. Bringing science and technology, dishwasher repair TDS. 100 bitties for everyone sub.
There's a reason she's alone. You can't pin her down because that needs her home. I need her around. She says there's beauty in the hills, chip in the sky, so don't.
Shut We'll be right back. I haven't done shit. Waiting for all my viewers to show up.
Waiting for all my viewers to show up. And stuff.
I am wearing my make relays great again. Relays. Yeah, but it was nobody for a good 10 minutes. All right. I wish this microphone had a way to clip on my neck, but not rub against my neck. I need to get a shirt. That's what I need to get one of those shot shirt things, and I can put. You know what I might be able to use?
Hang on.
Oh, yeah, I'm good. I got this fancy Free Play Florida thing. There. How's that work? Hey, that works. I'm not sure how well it sounds, but all right. This is a mess. This is some pina colada flavored candy. All right, so we got this dishwasher controller. Yes, I did. I had my own boxes. Did you like them or did you not like them? S'mores gave me a headache. Each time I ate one, I got a headache. It was very weird. I did that for all of them. Like, each time I'd eat one, I'd get a headache. I've never ate anything in my life that would give me a headache. Yeah, the birthday was good. Yeah, the s'mores was giving me a headache. Which I thought was weird. There might be something in it that was my body didn't like. I don't think the headaches had anything to do with that. This maybe it's you. Just kid. Alright, so what I have here is a dishwasher controller out of a very old Maytag dishwasher. The Maytag repairman told the person that it's broken. So, I was able to find some service documentation that'll allow me to hook power to this unit, push a bunch of buttons, and then I can manually energize each of these buttons, which is kind of cool. What I do need to do is figure out which of these relays does what before I try hooking the power up. Because I want to document the relays and see if I can figure out if I can get in here without having to electrocute myself. obviously I don't want to break it taking it apart. So we have some interconnect wires down here. Well, I did find a Molex connector I can use to power this. It does take 120 volts on the first two pins, which luckily he did take a picture. Nah, I'm gonna run full 120 volts right into the wall. No, I have an isolated transformer that I can use to hopefully to limit the amount of current to 175 watts instead of 1,000 or 2,000 watts out of the wall. So I got a variable I'll use to drive this. It'll be 120 volts, but it'll only be 175 watts. Sir, I'm trying to help people understand how my repair process is here. I don't want to overrush it. You should never rush working on anything. Rule number one in fixing things, don't rush it. Look, my raid lights are working. Last night's ghost, welcome in. Hello Raiders, how was your stream? I was able to catch it for a little bit before I had to get working on this crazy device. This is a dishwasher controller for a dishwasher. As you can tell, the raid lights are finally working. I updated the software to a beta version, and the beta version fixes all the broken problems. But I'm fixing a dishwasher controller. The Maytag repairman claims that it was broken and not working. One of the relays was bad. Hence the shirt I'm wearing. It says, make relays great again. So we're gonna try powering this device and then testing these relays. As my computer goes ding ding over there. Yeah, Maytag repairman was not able to fix it. Maytag repairman says you need a new dishwasher. So here I am. So I'm just trying to figure out how to take it apart without breaking it. Oh yeah, he's definitely wrong. I am pretty sure the actual issue of course is this is upside down. I'll show it this way. So the problem actually I'm pretty sure it's this door switch right here. This door switch provides 120 volts into the relay bank right here. Comes in on this wire here. The problem is you can't test this when the door is open. So I can test this through all the relays. So what? Yeah, well, I don't have the switch. The switch is part of the door. It's the door switch. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hook power to this, figure out which of these relays are what, and then I can hook power and then go through the different modes. There's rinse and hold, there's a bunch of different relays. There's a motor relay, a fill relay, a dispenser, rinse a dispenser relay, a vent wax motor, and a heater. So if you look here on the schematic, we have a detergent rinse dispenser. We have a water valve, which this looks like it's an input. This is another vent. This looks like some kind of something heating element. So these are all basically loads. This here is a, that's showing a diagram of a thermal switch. So if this gets too hot, the heater turns off. So a dishwasher has a heater element that heats the water inside the dishwasher to higher temps than you would get in your sink. So that's why you put the items that could potentially melt on the top part of the dishwasher, and then you put your heavier stuff down on the bottom because the bottom of the dishwasher has hotter water. But this is what controls the temperature of the water. It's a fixed temperature sensor. You can't adjust that volt, the temperature. This is a vent. This is just a basically power applies to it, opens up a vent, rinse door opens. There's a float switch, so when the water reaches a certain level, it will tell the circuit board to stop letting water in, which is probably controlled by this vent. And then there's a relay here that controls part of the motor. There is a overload protector inside the motor, but the guy said the motor wasn't getting any power. So we're gonna assume that he just checked at these leads, saw no power, said the circuit board was bad, and said the circuit board is no longer available. He needs a new dishwasher. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna power the circuit board through the power connector. We're going to put the in manual function mode, and then when it's in manual function mode, we'll be able to check each of these different relays. This indicates 5 relays, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 relays, and then there's this big relay right here, which is probably motor relay. So there is a guy on YouTube called, I think, Tech Tangents. He goes and does a very good review of a dishwasher, or how a dishwasher works. The most important thing about a dishwasher is before you start your dishwasher, make sure your sink water is actually hot. To turn on the hot water, let it run for a couple seconds, because normally your pre-wash doesn't have hot water. And if you get that hot water up to your sink, that means the dishwasher will have hot water coming in. It doesn't have to spend so much time heating it up. Because most of these functions are all timer based. So if it expects, if it's gonna do the pre-soak for 5 minutes. Yeah. Also, if you use those little detergent packs, always throw an extra one in the bottom of, take an extra one and throw it in the bottom of the dishwasher for free wash. So use two of the little packs, one in the door and one in the bottom of the dishwasher. And you can skip, if you get like I use finished dishwasher, which has jet dry, a power ball, and then dish detergent. I use that and I don't even put jet dry in the door. I don't even bother. All right, so first we're gonna try to figure out how to get this thing apart. Because I need to figure out which of these connectors goes to which relay. Also, it looks like some of these relays might go to these, and I just wanna make sure that this black wire, which is the hot line in, is what drives all these, it goes to all the commons on all these relays. I want to make sure that the power coming in on this connector is only going to this voltage section. So we get to figure out how to take this apart.
Looks like it snaps onto the PCB somehow. Okay, so it does snap onto the PCB. Okay, so these little tabs here. Bent over a little LED. Well, I got one out. Oh, no, they just slide on there. It looks like only, okay, the tab is on the bottom side. Ugh. All right, so I gotta go on the bottom side of the board and pull it free. Ugh. There's one. I gotta remember this is. Okay, I can figure that out. Now I gotta do the other one. It looks like I can actually fold the board flat, which is good. So some of these things are designed for some serviceability. Unlike cars, the actual person designing this actually designed it so that the board can be laid flat. Do is I'll remove these connectors and then the board will actually fold out somewhat, and that'll give me access to the buttons and kind of the backside. Now it's not fully there, but now we see the backside of the relays right here. And now what we're going to do is we're going to try to figure out which relay goes to what. So this relay here is going between, but here's the input signal right along here. So as you can tell by this smaller trace, this is the input, and that's also the input. So these are the inputs for the power on the relay. This is GY. This is PK, and this one is RD. So these three values, I'm just gonna write up right here on this piece of paper. So PK is primary, goes in, and then we have two outputs. GY and RD. All right, so that's this relay here. That's RL3. The RL3 connects between gray, red, and pink right here. This is what this one is, RL3. So it actually depicts it on the wiring diagram on the board right here as being a actually isolated input or an isolated relay. Next relay is, we're going to go with RL6. RL6 has, again, the two smaller traces on one end. Where'd my little pointy stick go? So this relay here, you can, that's the coil that energizes the relay, and that's the little contactor in there. So that's the input for the relay, and then it's just a normally open, normally closed switch, or normally open switch that closes, Then it connects the black, which is our live, to the motor output, which is blue. So this relay, RL6, is the motor relay, because there's no schematic available for this, so we have to reverse engineer what this thing does. And it connects BK to blue. So the good thing is I can test that with an ohmmeter. I can put an ohmmeter on there, and when I energize the motor, this should click, and then it should have resistance. Looking at the pads, it is a little charred in there. Could be an open relay. So no, just small brain. So if this relay is bad, the motor will never turn on, and the symptoms of bad control board is what he would get. I could remove this relay and test it on the bench manually if it doesn't click. So if I tell this to turn the motor on and this relay doesn't click, then there could be an issue with the circuit board. We'll then stop the test, remove the relay, manually apply power from my workbench over here, and see if the relay clicks that way. I could also test and check for voltage on the backside, which may be an option as well. All right, so we have identified two relays. We have four relays left. So relay number four, nope, relay number seven, connects up between, okay, relay number seven shares a common with all of the relay inputs, it looks like. So 1, 2, 3, okay, these relays are a little different layout than this guy over here. So these two, the power was here. These guys, so this relay here has five posts. Yes, I did get the dumplings. They finally did come in. I have not cooked the dumplings yet. I did cook two of the rices, or the two of the noodles that came with it. I posted them on my Instagram, the two different noodles I bought. The Dan Dan noodles and another one. I'm working on it, John. I'm working on it. Look, I had fire last week. Maybe we'll have fire this week. If not, I will find a lighter or something. I think I have a lighter right here. I can burn a piece of paper. We were working on Brian's dishwasher controller. Just trying to explain my logic on how I'm working on it. Yes, this is Brian's. We don't want to actually see fire. Then he'll be really sad. So this relay here is just a normally open relay. Okay, so the hot wire from line comes in right here on this guy right here, feeds this relay. Feeds this relay, feeds this relay. So it's feeding 1, 2, 3. Did that right? Okay, this is the orange lead. This is an orange lead with orange. Orange is for the heating element. So this one's heat goes here. Really a pain, because they put these coils in all different directions. Okay. There's the relay control, output, input. So this relay here, the one I'm looking at, RL7, connects DK to OR and is the heater relay. RL5, black wire, output goes out down towards the bottom, goes in 1, 2, 3, 4, pin number 4, which is going to be the detergent. That's BK to pin number 4, which is the number 4 wire. 1, 2, 3, 4. This one here, which is RL4, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 6 wire. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which is the vent. That goes BK to number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. By the way, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are actually tied together for the detergent. Vent is number 4. And then the last relay, which is this relay here, is not actually used in this circuit. It is used for something over here. So that might be a power relay. Or is it? Okay, there's the common. Nope, that's black coming in. Nope, goes to number 3. Number 3 is the water valve. So RL2 is the water valve, which goes to BK to number 3. So we have... So this is a speed. Doesn't look like we can test that one, but we can test the motor. We can test the fill, which is going to be this guy here. The detergent slash rinse aid, which is this guy here. So the motor is going to be RL6. The fill is going to be what they call water valve, which is RL2. Detergent dispenser is RL5. Vent wax motor. That's going to be relay 4. And then the heater is going to be RL7. So this, RL3 is a speed. All right, now that we have documented, figured out the wiring on the motors, the relays. All right, so we will explain why I have a 1998 dishwasher controller on my desk. Customer says it doesn't work. Call the Maytag service repair guy. It's Maytag. Maytags never fail. Comes out, looks at it, says the control board's bad, can't get it. Have a good day. And leaves. Don't know what else he did, but that's what they did. So I am going to confirm that this is either not working or it is working. He says it powered up. So I have located a service manual on the internet, which this is it. This is this whole service manual. There is a manual test function by pressing buttons. It's in this order. Boop, 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 boop. And then it will put it in a manual mode. And then by pushing each button, it will do something. So like if I push the pots and pans button, which is button number 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I push this button, it should then energize the motor. Yep, exactly. Flop jockey. I was able to unfold it and kind of I can put it on the bench like this. All right. So, next step is to hook power up. Let's use the thinnest wire I can possibly find. This should be good, right? So I have my isolation transformer over here. I have, that looks like a good usable cable. Going to bed, lightweight. All right. Trying to get power up here without stretching across the floor. So I'll just keep plugging different plugs in together. All right. So if I turn the power on, I'll have 120 volts right here. Okay, kids. Eat a bean before. All right, I'm gonna eat a bean. Oh, these things stink. One bean. Dead fish. Oh, I just ate. Oh. Oh. Oh God. Ugh. Why would you do that to me? Oh. I have a crimper for this, but I don't know where it's at. I'm going to use the improper tool. Have a good one, Ruby. Thanks for the follow. Oh, and yeah, I'm a variety streamer, so I do other things other than eat Bean Boozled and try to catch my house on fire. Thanks for the stop. Thanks for coming in on the raid. All right. If I did this right, gonna confirm on the back side that looks like power. Yep. Alright. Power's going around my house here. Uh-oh. It's reporting a power failure. Alright. So test mode should be press. Okay, I don't know about you guys. It looks like it's dead. Yeah, it's not doing anything. He said this thing lit up. Yeah, I see that. All right. Let's see if we can determine if there's something going on the power supply. Power is confirmed to be turned off. Let's see if we can figure out how this is working. Okay, so the good news is this is a non-switching power supply. This is a linear power supply. We have AC voltage coming in on the mains. We have AC voltage coming out. Looks like in two spots. We have here going to a diode bridge rectifier setup right here, which then comes out and goes to this big capacitor right here, which is not bulging. And then we have a standard 5-volt regulator. So what we can do is we can put our voltmeter in bolt mode. I don't have a fancy way for you guys to see my voltmeter. Turn on. Power fill light ain't coming on either. All right, so we're gonna go into AC volt mode and we're just going to check. We have 25 volts AC, 25 volts AC. All right, so we have 25 volts AC on that side. We We have 30 volts DC on that side. We have 5 volts DC coming out of the voltage regulator. We have 5 volts DC there. Well, I don't know about you guys, this thing looks dead. So we have what's called, turn the power off. Got the capacitor charged down. Just check that. All right, it's fully discharged. So we have a turbatory sensor, which is the sensor that's located in the bottom of the dishwasher. We have a water temperature thermostat, which just goes open and close. That's it for inputs. Everything else, all these pins are here. No, none of them are. There's 2 safety switches, but they're located outside. There's no power. There's no sensor to detect power coming in from BK, at least that I could see. And there's an optocoupler here. I mean, I could hook a wire up to BK. It does have a capacitor go across it. Or a resistor, which then goes to this input here. No. So there is an optocoupler here that looks like it's tied to this hot wire. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a jumper from here to this BK wire and just see if it does anything different. Which will simulate the door being closed. BK goes to here. All right, so that should simulate line voltage on BK. Nope, same thing. Little blinky light, nothing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's supposed to be test. The display will show 2 and will toggle individual functions on and off. So pots and pans, which is the 5th button over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To energize the motor relay. Alright, so now here's the problem. I kind of got to test this with a load. Because naturally, I have high voltage now. So I can use a multimeter. So it has a sensor to detect the door being closed. So if the door is open, let's see if the timer still runs. Let's see. So each mode runs, I think, for 2 minutes. So the button's supposed to turn off and on functions. The display will show 2 minutes and the keys will toggle individual functions on and off. The machine will automatically drain and shut off 120 seconds after the last key is pressed. So right now I simulate the door being open by pulling that. But none of the buttons are doing anything. They're all like locked out. So let's just see if the timer goes down. I mean, I can simulate closing the door again. That might just be needed to turn it on. Do 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 do. Doobie doobie do. Just check continuity between. Actually, let's just make sure there's not power. Okay, just make sure there's no power there. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna hook up this, which is our line voltage, and we're just gonna check the relays to see if any of these relays are hooked. Of course, I put this paperwork down here. Good job, Hammy. All right, so this should now be connected for the motor. It should be blue. Yep. Heater's off. Blue's on. Those three go to that. So the only one on right now is the motor relay. So, my issue with saying if the safety switch is bad, if that upper safety switch is bad, the unit doesn't come on. Now, it does appear to be locked up. So I'm just gonna turn it off, turn it back on. Up, but remembering where it was at last. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I can't get to go out of test mode. Okay, right now it's in test mode. Back in voltage. Neutral blue. So this is the guy that had the EM games. He posted on the Village about the shirts. He's what, $20 a shirt. It says, make relays great again. Who doesn't like us? What are you talking about? I paid for this shirt. All right. So RL6 is that button. That should be the motor relay. Yep, 123 volts on the motor relay. Normal cycle is the fill switch, which is the fourth button, which we determined was the RL2, which was number 3 post on this unit. 120 volts. Detergent RL5 is going to be pins 4 and 5, so confirming that those are turned off right now. They are both turned off. And that is going to be the China button, which was the second button. $123 right there. No problem, man. Looks like these are all good. I got one relay left, which is going to be the heater relay, which is going to be orange, confirming no power on orange, no power on orange. The button that turns on the heater is going to be the heated dry, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 5. $120. The only other one I think I didn't check was the vent one, which is pins number 6 on this little circuit thing. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nope, I did not check that one. Which is the vent. The vent is the IntelliClean button. It's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 7. I heard the relay click. Yep, I got power on all these pins. So all the relays are working. You can hear them clicking. Here. Five relays. That doesn't do nothing. That one doesn't do nothing. This one exits. That's the light. So I'm gonna say this works. I mean, I guess that would be normal wash, right? And then I guess you push normal wash again. Yep, relay just clicked. So that should be the motor relay, right? Blue. Nope, that should be the vent. Number 6 is the vent wire. Yep, it is currently got the vent operating. Yeah, so the trick is if you open the door, it stays on. But it locks out all the buttons. I can't exit. It literally locks the control panel. And if I close the door, they get the buttons again. So test mode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then there's those different. Exit. So there's normal wash, 2 hours. And it just turned on. So this works. I'm gonna give this board a clean bill of health. What I can do is I can go get a light bulb, hook a light bulb up and see if we get a light bulb working from through the relay. That will put a load on that motor relay. Let me see if I can find a light bulb. Light bulb discovered. All right, so we have a light bulb. Prove the light bulb works. Beep, we have light. All right, y'all see the light bulb work? Here, we get overhead cam, light bulb. I can dim the light bulb too. Let's see here, voltage. So, that light bulb, that's 60 volts. That's 120 volts. And that is consuming 30 watts. All right, there's our light bulb. So I still need this T in here. Right. I need 2 Molex pens. All right, 2 Molex pens. Verify the power is turned off. All right. So we have neutral, 120 volts. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this out of here. I'm gonna put it over here. Then I'm gonna take another test lead. We're gonna come off the neutral side of this and we're gonna go to the light bulb. And then we're gonna come off of the light bulb. And then we're gonna go to the motor relay. All right. going to test. Test. So, motor relay is definitely working. I think that's the only one. Oh, we have the heater relay, which is right here. The heater relay was this one? This one? This one? There's the heater relay. Nope. There's that relay. There's that relay. And the other one's in the pen holder there. I can't get to it. So, I'm gonna say there's nothing wrong with this. I don't know. I have no idea. I will let them know that there's nothing wrong with this, and that his Maytag repair guy is full of shit. Like I originally said, I will see him tomorrow night, and I will talk to him and see exactly what. These are all my adapters for all my different monitors for when I do arcade monitor repair. I don't use jumper clips to hook up all the different tests, all the arcade monitors. I use the proper connectors and actually hook them up so I don't have sparks flying. I'll just leave that connector on there. And off camera over here, I have a Sencor AC PowerRite isolation transformer. This is also a good device to use for testing and putting a load on the high voltage side of a lot of arcade monitors. You can isolate the power supply section and use this to load and test fix like on a 7500 medium res monitor. That all back in the box. All right, that's put away. Turn this meter off. Put that over there. All right, let's put this thing back together. There was two of these. And of course, naturally, they are not the same. So I do have the front panel. The holes do not line up. So we will need to figure out which one goes where. Luckily, that's how it goes. All right, so that's the bottom one, and this is the top one. All right, that concludes the testing and repair of a Maytag dishwasher control board, which actually had nothing wrong with it. So I'm gonna write these notes down. Made on here just so they get lost in translation and everyone figures out what they are. So RL3 is the only relay we could not test. RL3 controls motor speed, so that's the start motor. So this one here, so how this works is power comes in. So this relay, if this start relay is bad, that's gonna cause a no motor issue as well. Because this relay, basically when the power comes into this, when the power comes in and energizes this motor, it'll draw this relay down, which then runs neutral up to here, which then goes, so normally neutral is on this wire here on start, but as soon as this motor gets a load and starts going, this relay will energize, this relay will drop down, moving the neutral to this line here. The one's drain, one's wash, which is weird because gray, red, and pink. Okay, all right. That's the motor reverse controller. Now I got it. So when the motor has power, this relay will energize, bringing neutral into up here. And depending on if this motor, this relay is on or off, either the drain will be turned on or the wash will be turned on. So depending on if this relay is energized, it's going to be either one of those. So the yellow wire could always be neutral. The blue should be hot on run. Red should be neutral and drain. Gray should be neutral on wash. Speak English. All right. I will try to explain this again. Let me just switch to the camera view here so you can see what I'm talking about here. So we have 120 volts comes in. We have two door safety switches. So normally the power is fed into here, gives the logic board power. If this switch is bad, this will think the door is open. If this switch is bad, none of the devices will have a neutral feed, which will give him the symptoms that he's reporting of no power. So this door switch might be the door switch that's possibly bad. So I'm gonna go with this door switch is bad. He could technically bypass this door switch because none of these relays are energized. So that could be, he could test that by just bypassing that switch. Doesn't want to bypass this one because if the door is open, there should be a door lock, but if he opens it, you'd have water go everywhere. Not a good idea. So anyways, when this circuit turns on the motor, it connects the black wire, which is 120 volts, to the blue wire, the blue terminal, which then brings 120 volts on this line here. This wire is connected to neutral, which is going to energize the start relay, which will then bring the neutral up into here through this relay, which then comes back and drives the wash motor. But that's how this RL3 works. I wish there was a way to test the RL3 button, but I don't see there is a way. There's not a So I'm guessing it goes in the drain when you're done pressing the last button. Because the machine will automatically drain and shut off 120 seconds after the last key is pressed. So RL6 is the motor, which is goes to the blue wire. Phil, RL2, went to vent, and it goes to the number 3 terminal. Number 5 is the detergent, which goes to the number 4 and number 5 terminal. RL5 is the vent. This is actually pretty simple. I mean, honestly, I would be like, if this thing was broke, I would just replace it with toggle switches. I always says vent wax motor. I mean, I guess they used to use wax back in the day. Which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is terminal number 6. And then the heater is the orange. That's so what was the number 3? Number 3 is that one, which is the fill. They call this fill, but it's not really fill. Fill. 4 and 5 are actually tied together. And if you look at the diagram, the picture he took, there's neutral. There's hot. This blue wire is number 3. Looks like number 4 is right there, which is also a blue wire. And then there's a purple wire, which is number 5. I can't tell, but you need to buy him a better camera. Nothing hooked up to number 7. There's 3, and then this is heat. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then this is motor. So if he still doesn't have, so if the motor's not working or he's not getting any power or any of this, I'm gonna suspect this door switch is bad. Because that door switch won't allow neutral to come to any of these devices. So if you took a multimeter across this, you're not gonna get anything. Multimeter across any of these, you're not gonna get any voltage or anything because this neutral leg, this whole lower neutral leg is dead because this door switch is bad. I'm gonna go with this bad door switch. If this door switch is good, then it's something ate his wiring. Because the water vent valve, the fill valve should still work. It should still pump water. All these other, you can't really tell if these ones are doing anything, but you definitely could tell if the vent, the water valve is working, if you turn on fill. Because that doesn't use the motor. Yeah, the stupid crap they put on there to prevent you from servicing it. I mean, and really, honestly, retrospect, this is just like, okay, turn water on. None of the circuits. Sorry, nothing caught fire. I failed everyone. No fire. Let me see if I can find a lighter. No, I have one. Oh, here we go. I can do this. Promise some fire. Let's see if I can. Any paper. Blow up a capacitor. All right. Okay. I can do that. All right. Blowing up a capacitor. Let me see what I got for capacitors. Alright, we got two experiments. We can A, hook a capacitor up backwards, and B, hook up, put too much power to a capacitor. So the first one we're gonna do is we're going to put too much power into a capacitor. So this is a 16 volt capacitor. Negative lead, positive lead. All right. And only because I don't want to smell this. All right, here we go. Okay. Well, my power supply is doing weird shit. Like the voltage is going everywhere. All right, so we're at 12 volts, 14 volts. All right, so we're at 16 volts, which is theoretically the maximum voltage for the capacitor. 17 volts. All right, so which voltage do we think it's gonna go at? We're at 18 volts. We're 20 volts. 22 volts. 23 volts. 25. 26, 28. 30 volts. A very anticlimactic capacitor. I use a 16 volt cap. I'm running 30 volts into it. not even warm. All right, let's do the other thing. Let's hook it up backwards. All right, so it's hooked up backwards now. I know it's going to go poof. What voltage do we think it's going to go poof at? Under 10 volts, between 10 and 20, or over 20? All right. Frenzy. Adair. Whims. Anybody else? Going once? Going twice? Going three times? Science requires safety goggles. Fine. Fine, 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 fine. You are right. You are right. My glasses are on. All right. John, 30 volts is my maximum voltage on this power supply. So we'll just say at 30 volts for you. All right, here we go. 2 volts. 3 volts. 5 volts. 6 volts. 7 volts. 10 volts, 12 volts, 13 volts, 15 volts, what? 20, what? All right, I'm gonna try something here. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna turn off the power supply. Oh, I never flipped it around. All right. This is gonna blow. What? How did that not blow? I just shot 30 volts into it instantly. All right, positive on the negative side. That's 30 volts hooked backwards to a capacitor. Oh, I do have a current. I do have current. Oh, current's going up. Current's rising. Oh, oh, get me a drink. It's gonna blow. Oh, there, oh, oh, it's going. Half an amp. There you go. There you go. There you go. You had your fire. 30 volts. And a 16 volt cap. Alright, well there was the fire I promised. Alright, let's switch screens. Helps if I plug my camera in. Hello! Oh! My office smells of a pretty burned up cap. Alright, Alright, it's 10:46. I'm done with my science experiments. We only had one person with 100 biddies. Oh yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4 new follows. Yeah. Thank you for the follows. I did not see them. Must have been during that raid. Hugger of Penguins, right lovely, Nukem 999 and Ruby T. I did get Ruby T. Thank you for the follow. And everyone else who hung out during the raid. I don't know if last night's ghost is still around, but if not, I hope you're having a lovely evening. Anybody else who stuck around during the raid? Let's see. Where do we want to go? Do we want to go to a science raid, a science stream? Do we want to go to a music stream? Turtles and chill. Let's see if science. Science is not streaming. Here we go. Let's check out this guy here. Let's see what he's doing. Doing woodworking. All right, let's see what else we got for options. Let's see if the knife making guy is going. No. All right, let's do this one. Nah, we're not going there. All right, guys, we're gonna go to this one. All right, we'll go to some software developer guy. Y'all want to watch some software developing? Looks like he's currently. Doing some random software development. Let's do that. Let's I'll stick around for the raid. There's my non-raid. Here is and there is the sub raid. So if you're a subscriber, please copy the sub raid text. If you're not a subscriber, please select the non.
M is for read.
But now if I do sub raid 2,